Hello and welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video, we elaborate to you how to design a shipping container house. The six important things to consider when designing a shipping container house. Stay tuned to find out more. Good, welcome back. Designing a home using shipping container modules is not similar to homes designed to be built with traditional building materials like stone, brick, or timber. Shipping containers come with inherent challenges, including constricted dimensions in the width and the height, which are fixed. In addition, containers are also made of coated steel, and the only way to transform these steel boxes into habitable space is through serious modification. The only way to circumvent these restrictions is through good design. If you are planning to build a shipping container house as a DIY project, here are the six important things to consider when designing a shipping container house. First, you need to consider the local climate. It is good to design with climate because the climate of the area where you intend to build will determine the type of ventilation to use in your shipping container house. If you are building in the tropics, you can use passive design, which will allow you to use natural ventilation methods like cross ventilation. Local climate will also dictate the type of insulation to use. If you are building in the tropics, the biggest challenge is to keep away heat from your shipping container, and therefore you can use any type of insulation. However, if you are building in the cold climate regions, you need to adopt an insulation material that has got good R values and good moisture barrier properties to keep away the cold and conserve heat at the same time, preventing condensation from happening. The type of roof to use also on your shipping container will depend on the local climate. If you live in areas that experience high levels of precipitation, it is advisable to put an additional pitched roof on top of your shipping container. The roof can be either gable, hipped, or lean-to. If you live in areas where rain is not an issue, then you can live with a flat roof, either as a rooftop deck or as a planted roof. Lastly, under climate, you need to consider the type of foundation to use. If you live in areas that experience, for example, perennial flooding, you will need to use a foundation that is elevated, and therefore a pile foundation would be a good alternative. The second thing you need to consider when designing a shipping container house is the design brief. How much space do you need in your shipping container house? For example, if you look at these two plans, this first plan here is designed using two 20-foot shipping containers, but you are able to accommodate a fully functional one-bedroom housing unit. On the second plan, we've used a single 40-foot shipping container, and we've also managed to accommodate a one-bedroom shipping container house. The type of plan you use or you need will depend on what are your special requirements. You'll also decide if you need an open plan layout for your living space. Lastly, you also need to decide if you need multifunctional spaces in your shipping container house, especially if you are designing a studio cabin or a container cottage. The third thing you need to consider is structural modifications. You need to ask yourself, how much cutting and welding is necessary or do I need in my shipping container house? If you do over modification, it means you escalate the costs of putting up your shipping container project. I have two floor plans here that I will show you exactly what I mean. On this first floor plan, you can see all the middle internal container walls have been removed to create a three-bedroom layout using two 40-foot shipping container. On the second floor plan, we have almost the same provision of spaces. If you look at these two arrangements, in the second floor plan, we've retained all the middle walls, save for the space around the master bedroom. Other than that, you'll find that we are spending very little in terms of cutting and welding when it comes to the second floor plan. With more modifications, it means more cutting, it means more welding, which will also translate to extra reinforcement, especially for this kind of arrangement where you have an open plan living room. You will need to put additional beams on the ceiling. There's another issue that comes with shipping containers, which is waterproofing. The roofs of shipping containers and the floor should not be interfered with as much as possible because they are very difficult to restore once they are messed up. And for that reason, as shelter mode, we do not advise cutting the roof or the floor of the shipping containers. The fourth thing you need to consider is furniture and interior design. As you have realized, with those restricted dimensions of shipping containers, especially on the width, which is approximately 2.4 meters wide, you'll find that most standard furniture hasn't been designed for such small spaces. So this will call you to consider a different approach when it comes to furnishing your shipping container house. You need to consider looking at fixed furniture, like creating a sitting bench and providing additional storage underneath so that you take care of all the limited and any available space. You need to also consider space-saving furniture ideas like using a wall-in bed or a Murphy bed, which will be used as a bed at night, and during the day you can use it as a study table or a storage shelf. Lastly, under that section, you need to look at interior colors. Because these spaces are tiny, it's advisable you use light colored finishes so that you make the space appear brighter and bigger and kill that claustrophobic feel of living in a tiny steel box. The fifth item you need to look at is outdoor living. Because shipping containers have limited space on the inside, it is advisable you provide as much outdoor living space to compensate for the limited indoor space in a shipping container house. So you can approach this by providing various outdoor spaces like a roof deck on top of your shipping container roof. If ground floor space is not a limitation, then you can extend outwards by creating an outdoor terrace, or you provide Juliet balconies by using the original container doors and use them in an open position, and then you weld them into place and provide an additional outdoor space in form of a Juliet balcony with adequate protective railing. Last but not least, the sixth item you need to consider seriously when designing a shipping container house is what we call fenestrations, or in other words, openings within your shipping container house. You need to provide adequate openings so that you can enhance daylighting. Adequate daylighting means less use of artificial lighting, especially during the day. And then you'll also achieve another advantage of providing adequate ventilation, by opening the windows during the day to allow in the cool breezes and therefore help you regulate the indoor temperature of your shipping container house. You will need to also adopt full height windows or doors to at least allow in maximum daylighting and also provide unrestricted access. You can also remove the original container doors and replace them with full height sliding doors. Sliding doors are more preferable in a shipping container house as opposed to swing doors because good space savers to use in a shipping container project. So we hope you found our presentation informative enough to help you design your own shipping container house. You are encouraged to give us your input by posting in the comments below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it. Remember to subscribe and see you in the next video.